dear students, welcome to a session on report writing. It's a doubt clearing session and you may ask questions whatsoever is coming to your own mind, but the range of question must be covering report writing, kinds of report, lengths of report, parts of a report, terms of reference, collection of facts, outlines of report, examples of report, and not beyond this. So the session is dedicated to a doubt clearing session on report writing, and questions would be from these specified areas related to report writing. So over to you. If you wish to ask any question, feel free to ask.
Start.
I want to ask the question that is the report for only giving information or does it also seek action?
It's really nice question. Came out of your curiosity that is report for only seeking information or seeking action. A report is only well functional, it gains its value. And a good report will go for authenticity of the data collection, processing the same and drawing conclusion based on that, and then it must have suggestions and recommendations that to defining the time and position. If the report is investigative, again it will be suggesting some conclusion and some action. If it is judicial in nature, again it will conclude by recommending some action related to punishment. If it is criminal, some offense is there, so it will go for that. So range of report depending on the type. Your question is like that, if somebody is writing press report and covering an event, so it will not seek some action. It will be carrying only solicited information or non-solicited information, but it will not be seeking action. It may or may not. Both the situation. It may seek action, it may not. But report definitely has its functional and recommendational and implementational value. Okay, I am having certain question sent by the audience on these slips and I will try to answer them one by one. First of all, again I would like to reiterate the definition of report. A report is a factual, truthful, objective account of some incident, some accident, some happenings that has happened, seen, witnessed, observed or investigated. Report can be of two types, informal and formal report, and another category, broad category, may be oral as well as written report. So related to these areas, whether a report, informal report may seek or may not seek any action, formal report sometime also if it is press report. So there are statutory, non-statutory report, there are solicited and non-solicited report, there are report to the higher management, report to the functional management and all. But one more thing one must take into account, and the question is asked from your side, that what is a well-defined audience? The first question I am having in my hand, that what is a well-defined audience. Report is always prepared for an audience that is specified, that is specific, particular audience. Audience may be professional audience, executive gathering, or an overall audience division analysis can be categorized into three parts: technical audience, semi-technical audience, and non-technical audience. The audience that is technical or professional audience will be from a specific field. Report to the higher management, so audience is readership is higher management. So who is going to read is the audience of the reader. Who is going to take action based on the report is the audience of the report. So that way, readership is the audience of any written formal report. When we talk of technical professional audience, so professional may be like if it is a medical report, so doctor is going to take action on that. He is supposed to be the audience of that report. If it is FIR, so police is going to take the action and interrogate and investigate. So he is the audience. All the specified field where the report is seeking action or the person who is supposed to read, interpret and take action, initiate action based on it is the audience. But for like press report is having a very complicated and complex sort of audience. It is for everybody and anybody. So let us come to the category professional and technical audience. Semi-technical audience, who is not that much expert and but they are also part of the readership. Then there can be non-technical audience. Furthermore, the non-technical audience can be categorized into three parts: literate audience, semi-literate audience and illiterate audience. So based on that, like somebody is a layman, some functional worker, laborer, but he is to function or work or put his labor, whether he is skilled labor or unskilled labor, put his labor according to the guidance of the recommendation of a leader, some building is to be constructed, some action is to be initiated. All these things will be the part of that. So well-defined audience, what is well-defined audience? I wanted to highlight this part in my answer. And again I am repeating, technical or professional audience, not semi-technical or semi-professional audience, non-technical or non-professional audience, non-technical and non-professional audience can be categorized into three part again: literate, semi-literate and illiterate audience. Next question is, what is terms of reference? While talking of referencing system, what should we reference, give as reference and what should we not? In the preparation of a report, we touch upon a lot many sources and we need to focus that source, we need to refer that source by acknowledging academic courtesy, professional courtesy. That source may be printed form or it may be in the web form, soft form, digital form. So if according to, there are many patterns of referencing, like one is MLA style guideline. What is MLA style guideline? Modern Language Association of America. This is compiled by, recommended by Joseph Gibaldi and it is revised time to time again, time and again. So latest is 8th and 9th edition of MLA handbook. But most of the academics in South Asian countries, they follow MLA 8th edition. According to MLA 8th edition, one should go for, suppose that there is a book and name of the book is Technical Writing and it is written by R. H. Sharma. So while referring, you will write Sharma, comma, R dot S dot, and then you will write in italics form, technical writing, and then name of the publisher, Radha Publication, suppose that, and then there is comma, New Delhi, year of publication, and later on your reference part is web or print. So inside the bracket you will write print. And there is another system known as author date system of referring. So you will write where you will refer, you will write R. S. Sharma, then date, which year published, publication year, suppose that the book is published in the year 2019. So the year 2019.